Hi everyone, thanks a ton for your responses to my previous video. It feels really awesome. So let me today show you the place in my home which is my favorite and that helps me to focus on my Bowerspace. Well, today I will take you through my study or the home office that I typically call it. In this video, I will tell you 10 tricks to organize your study table or the desk to increase your productivity at work or while in studies and help you to efficiently manage a lot of time. Remember that these tricks are suitable even for a smaller study table purchased ready-made from the market. What you see here is a picture of my study table in my previous rented house. So nothing much has changed in the way I have organized from here to my bigger study table which is there right now. So let's not waste much time and let's begin. Always keep the top of your desk clutter-free. My husband and I share this table. We like to keep the tabletop free from unwanted things, especially while working. It makes us feel more focused and balanced. When I planned for the layout of this table, I couldn't keep its width in the usual dimension. If you notice, it is a bit smaller. So keeping it clutter-free is the only way to give me more room to work. Keep necessary things handy but make sure that they are in a working condition. For me, the worst nightmare is not being able to find a pen. If we find one, it may not work. It has happened to all of us at some point of time. Now, keeping necessary things handy in a pen stand on the table or in your drawer gives you less time to search and more time to do your work. That way, focus is not diverted. Partition your drawers to prevent them from messing up. Using drawer dividers or small baskets will sort the necessary stationery items. As you can see, I was able to accommodate not only the supplies but my diary, post-it pads, an emergency yoga bar, my spectacles case, my Fitbit tracker, and pencils and a marker. In the behind, you can see I have utilized the space to keep my bookmarks. Now, isn't that a well-utilized space? The next trick is to segregate and keep same type of things in the same place. Now, this is the upper cabinet of my desk. Everything here is well sorted and labeled. Most of these are not used every day, but they are useful. I have used small bottles to hold the craft items. The mason jars with chalk give an aesthetic appeal to the area. The lazy Susan here makes it easy for me to access the pens. Now, I had ended up accumulating a lot of stuff which I now want to give away to needy children. As I always say, do not have a hoarding mentality. Now, this drawer here is home to important things that are frequently needed. Laptop cleaner, cleaning cloth, all the cello tapes in one place. Marker pens, my snack, correction pens, passport size photographs, my little notepads, post-it pads, they're all well sorted and kept together in one single place in this drawer. Now all types of diaries and notepads that I ever have and that the ones that I use are all in this one single drawer, well organized. In this drawer, I have visiting card holders, one of which is used to keep my membership cards. I carry them when I go out for shopping. Save a space for unsorted or junk papers. You can also use a box for it. There is not a single household that does not accumulate bills, receipts, and all other types of unwanted papers. I use this topmost drawer to my right to keep them. I periodically sort them, store them, or dispose them. Important trick: let your desk have a pin-up board or a magnetic whiteboard, or perhaps both. A pin-up board and a whiteboard are both very important tools to remain less forgetful. They help you from being out of sight, out of mind. At least for me, note making helps me remember things much better. Keep a marker and a pen right on top of the boards for convenience. After all, you do not want to forget what you wanted to write while searching for the pen, isn't it? Use wire managers to avoid jumbled cables. Now, if you notice, you won't find any wires or cables hanging in the picture of my study, because this is what I have done. I provided a slot in the behind of my study table that could hold the laptop cable and the printer cord. I have used rubber bands and Velcro to keep the wire tied up in a place. Very, very important. Keep a dustbin next to your desk. Whenever I sort papers, the dustbin really comes handy. And if you are a student doing a project, you will have enough dirt and junk to throw away. Why dirty your surroundings when you can have a bin? Very important for your efficiency, make sure you have comfortable chairs. Good, comfy chairs will have tremendous effect on your efficiency and productivity. You will avoid yourself getting distracted from lower back pains. Just a suggestion out of experience. However comfortable your chairs may be, get up from your seats and take a slight stroll. It'll help in blood circulation. Remember to keep your posture correct at all times. Last but definitely not the least, do not compromise on lighting. Now this is an unedited picture of my study area with natural lighting, and this is how lighted it is when in the night time. Good lighting has a lot of impact on your eyesight, leading to lack of concentration, and you know it well that lack of concentration means lack of productivity. So friends, these are a few things that I follow to stay organized in my home office and keep myself super productive. Hope you all find it useful, especially at this time when schools have started for most of the kids. So friends, thanks again for being patient and watching this long video. Please give me a thumbs up if you liked it and don't forget to subscribe. I will be back soon with a new video. Till then, be organized, be productive and be happy. Bye-bye.